spreading around. Your life takes its time. Right to check outside the game.
Hello and welcome to Calvary Update. I'm your host, Father Jay. It's good to be back with you. We have a lot in store for us today on the Calvary Update, so stay tuned as we get through all of the news of the week. But I want to, first of all, start off with our top 10 list. Our top 10 list brought to us from the home office in Aberdeen, Scotland. This week, as we are entering into the season of our annual meeting and so forth, this week we have the top 10 reasons why you should run for vestry. Top 10 reasons to run for vestry. Number 10. When you're in the vestry, you get to explain to your non-Episcopal friends what a vestry is. No one will know what that word means. So you get to explain to them not only that you are on the vestry, but that the vestry is a thing that actually exists. The number nine reason to run for vestry is that when you join the vestry, you get to explain to your Episcopal friends what a vestry is. Most Episcopalians, I think, struggle to understand the roles and responsibilities of a vestry member, so you'll have the opportunity to learn all about that and explain it to your fellow parishioners. So think about the knowledge that you will get to share with your Episcopal friends and your non-Episcopal friends when you run for the vestry. Number eight on our top 10 reasons to run for vestry. When you join the vestry at Calvary Church, it comes with an automatic membership on the Calvary Food Pantry Board of Directors. That's right, you may not be aware of this, but all of the members of the vestry also make up the membership of the Board of Directors of the Calvary Episcopal Church Food Pantry Incorporated, a separate 501c3 nonprofit corporation. Now, the day-to-day activities of the food pantry are largely carried out by the Food Pantry Executive Committee, but at least twice a year, the vestry meets as the Food Pantry Board of Directors and approves membership on the executive committee, hears updates, so forth and so on. So if you want to be a part of that illustrious group, you too may join the vestry. Number seven reason to join the vestry at Calvary Church is that you get to see Calvary in the evenings and on the weekends. During the week, get to see Calvary in the evenings and during the week. If you've never seen Calvary at nighttime because you've only come here during the day or on Sunday mornings for services, then you have missed a treat. Get to see Calvary at nighttime and during the week by joining the Calvary Vestry. Number six reason for joining the Calvary Vestry: you will get the vestry minutes and the vestry agendas emailed directly to you. That's right, every month you will receive the minutes of the previous month and the agenda for the meeting that come in an email that comes directly to your inbox. No more having to look all over the Calvary website to find past minutes. You can find them in the vestry section of the website. And no more wondering what the vestry might be talking about at the meeting to come. Get all of that emailed directly to your inbox. Number five reason to become a member of the vestry of Calvary Church is that you can become a Sunday almoner. not almond, not, we're not, you can have a nut allergy and still serve on the vestry. What we are talking about are the people who take the collection, the alms, count it, and put that into the bank safe deposit box to be retrieved on Monday by our office staff and counted and deposited. So you have the opportunity to become an almoner on Sunday mornings as a member of the vestry. Number four reason for joining the Calvary Episcopal Church vestry is that you will get to practice evening prayer and compline and other services you don't normally get the chance to participate in. Every meeting of the vestry includes an opportunity for worship and reflection. And so if you are a member of the vestry, you get to experience all sorts of different worship opportunities from the prayer book. Number three on our top 10 reasons for joining the vestry is that you get to retreat. That's right. In periods when we are not experiencing a national and global pandemic, the vestry does have an annual retreat, which consists of at least a day, perhaps an overnight, where we discuss the plans and activities of the vestry and look forward to the year ahead and what we might want to focus on. So you will get to participate in a wholesome and edifying retreat as a member of the vestry. Number two on the top 10 list of reasons to join the vestry is the opportunity to participate in important discussions about the life and the mission of this parish. That's right. The vestry is the place where we think about the big picture and look to the future, where we check in on the life and the pulse of the parish. And so if you'd like to participate in those discussions, the vestry is the place to do those. And finally, the number one reason for joining the vestry of Calvary Church, for running for membership, for election to the vestry, is that you get the opportunity to serve with some great people. I'm sorry, we have great folks on the vestry. They are passionate about Calvary Church. They're passionate about our life together, and they enjoy being with one another. So if you want to join in that activity, then perhaps you too will want to run for the Calvary vestry. So those are our top 10 reasons. That's our top 10 list from the home office in Aberdeen, Scotland. And we thank them for sending that to us today. Now, speaking of running for vestry, vestry elections, of course, take place at our annual meeting. Our annual meeting has been scheduled for February the 13th. So just about 3 weeks from now. Our vestry, in looking at the current number of cases of COVID-19 and their prevalence and so forth, has decided that it would be prudent to delay the annual meeting until February the 27th at the earliest. So I know you had on your calendars that we would meet on the 13th and you had blocked that day off, but I ask your forbearance and your understanding in light of this pandemic that we need to move the meeting to the 27th. So please mark that on your calendars. Speaking of COVID-19, the latest COVID-19 numbers are out, and while there is still plenty of reason for concern, there is also some good news and reason for hope. The latest numbers show a dip in the number of cases as a percentage of the total population, both in Buncombe and in Henderson counties. And while that still leaves us just below the 2% range, which is greatly elevated and much higher than we would like to see it, there is some hope that that is the beginning of a downward trend. As we have talked about in the past, this particular variant, the Omicron variant, has increased infections rapidly. There has been a spike in infections. So the hope is that there will be just as rapid a decline in the number of infections as this variant moves through the population. So we are, we're hopeful about that. We look for it to continue. We'll continue to track that. But one of the things to note is that what we are seeing locally is a mirror in a lot of ways of what is being reported nationally. There's a graph on your screen where the national trend is marked in green and the local trends are marked in blue and in gold. And you can see that all are trending in the same direction. Here in Western North Carolina, we were a little bit behind in terms of the onset or the pickup of this variant, but we're starting to see it decline in much the same way that it is declining in other areas of the country. So there's reason to be hopeful at this point. Again, we're not out of the woods yet. So we ask that you would continue to follow the guidelines and the protocols that are laid down, particularly in terms of always wearing a mask when you are inside the building here at Calvary, and when you are participating in worship services, that you would respect the protocol that only choristers will participate in singing the music. Singing is still one of those behaviors that we have reason to have a heightened concern for. And so we ask that folks would refrain from that in the congregation. I do appreciate that as folks have come to attend services, you've taken the steps to spread out within the space here at Calvary. It is okay to sit down front. It is okay to sit in the back. It's okay to sit on the sides. It's okay to sit more towards the center. But as we continue through this pandemic, appreciate your continued attention to the protocols for COVID-19. Also, of course, winter weather continues here in the mountains. We're still watching snow melt from our weather event about 10 days ago, and it seems like every Tuesday or Wednesday we hear the predictions of possibilities for snow on the weekends. I know for many individuals and businesses, pardon me, having winter weather on the weekends is more desirable. For us, of course, it's a little more challenging in terms of making decisions about whether or not we will have services and what those will look like. In any case, we will do our very best to make a decision by the very latest at 7 a.m. on Sunday mornings, if not before. We will publish that decision on our website. We will publish that decision on our Facebook page. We will publish that decision to our email group, and we will attempt to publicize that decision on the closing lists of WLOS TV. So you can look in one of those places or more than one of those places for weather closure information. But please be mindful of that. And if you're not signed up, for instance, for our email newsletter, please go ahead and do that so you can be sure to have this and all of the other information. We are looking forward to some upcoming events here at Calvary Church in the coming weeks and months. We are looking forward on February the 20th to a project particularly involving the children, youth, and young people of the church, but to which anyone is invited. On February the 20th, Mother Nan will be leading a project to decorate a veneration cross, a cross that is used in particularly in the Tizay form of worship that folks can interact with and reverence and meditate with. And this particular cross has been designed by Ted Hill and has spaces for individual plaques to be put in it. And so it is those individual plaques that we will be inviting the children, young people, youth, and anyone who wants to participate to decorate and insert those. And then obviously those can change over time. But that will be February 20th at 4 p.m. Then February 26th, from 1 to 4 p.m., Mother Nan will be offering a spirituality and the arts workshop at Arden Woods on Brevard Road. That opportunity is open to members of Calvary Church as well. So I encourage you to contact Mother Nan if you are interested in that opportunity. And know that there will be further opportunities later in the year. So if you're interested in either or both of those, that's the Cross Project or the Spirituality and the Arts Project or Workshop, please email Mother Nan and she can give you more information. And just know that going forward in Lent, we will have offerings of night prayer on Sunday evenings at 6 p.m. And we will have offerings of food and formation on Wednesday evenings in Lent, also starting at 6 p.m. So put those on your calendars, 6 p.m. Sunday and Wednesday during Lent. There will be special worship services and food and formation presentations. And of course, Lent begins on Ash Wednesday. That's Wednesday, March the 2nd. We'll have Ash Wednesday services at noon and then again in the evening that day. So please join us for all of those activities and all that is happening here at Calvary Church. And between now and then, we do pray that God will bless you and keep you, that God's face will shine upon you and give you peace both now and in the days to come. Amen.